Hi guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Jagusheni. I hope that you're doing well and that you're taking care of those around you, because we are living in very difficult times. And if you have to travel, or if your loved ones have to travel in these difficult times out of compulsion, then you must be very worried. So I recently had to travel from India to the UK because of work. And in this video, I'm going to share with you my experience of traveling from India to the UK and the COVID situation. And I hope that hearing about my experience and the precautions that I had to take, all the travel rules, all the international travel rules, and everything that you have to do during your travel and after that, knowing about all of that from this video is going to put your worries to rest and is going to give you a clearer picture if you're looking forward to traveling soon, or you know, if someone that who is close to you is traveling and you're worried for that person. So I'm going to share with you my entire experience, starting from the very beginning. So not only that, in this video I'm going to talk about the Kolkata to London direct flight that started only recently. This is a flight that the people of Kolkata had been waiting for the longest time, for years actually, and finally it started. So and I traveled by it only yesterday. So I hope that if you just want to find out how the flight was, the Air India flight that will fly you direct from Kolkata to London, then please keep watching this video and make sure that you hit the bell icon after you have hit the subscribe button, so that you get notified every time I upload a video. Without further ado, let's get started. This video is going to be quite long, so make sure that you have some tea or coffee or some kind of a drink while you're watching. So first things first, the Kolkata to London direct flight was a 10 and a half hours long flight. The flight was very smooth. It was very turbulent free, and it reached actually before time. So it left at 6:30 a.m. and it reached Heathrow. It lands in Heathrow. I think as of now the direct flight only lands in Heathrow. So it reached in Heathrow at around 4:20 p.m. which at around 4:20 p.m. IST, and in the local time in here it reached at around 11:20 a.m. which was like an hour before when it was scheduled to reach. So that was great. There are a lot of complications when it comes to flying right now, with international travel being restricted in so many airports. So because I was traveling from Kolkata to London, I was asked to do a COVID test 72 hours prior to my travel. So I needed to do a COVID test. I had to have a negative COVID test report that I needed to carry to the airport before traveling, and the test should have been done within 72 hours before my date of travel. So that is one rule. The second rule is, of course, you have to wear masks and you have to carry your supply of sanitizers and all of that. But when you do reach the airport, after you know you have passed through the baggage check-in and immigration, after that, before boarding, you are given this safety kit, and in it there's this mask, there's a shield, and there are sanitizing wipes. So these are the three things, and you have to wear the mask and the shield before you board your flight. Now the Kolkata airport was quite empty, so immigration was smooth. So you know, the check-in, the security, all the queue there was not very long. However, I wouldn't say that, you know, it was very empty, because people were traveling. The flight, there were actually people who were going for some film shooting, but then again, that is work as well. So people were mostly flying for work. So yeah, that went really smoothly. Another thing that you must do, so this is the pre-travel checklist. There are two other things that you should do. If you're traveling by Air India, it is compulsory that you do a web check-in before you travel. So you have to do that within 24 hours of your travel date. So you have to web check in. For that, you need to go to the Air India website. You have to give your PNR number and you just have to check in. So yes, I think the web check-in had been made mandatory because of COVID, or that was what I was told. And there's another thing that you must do, because if you do not do that, it is definitely going to be a problem once you reach the UK. So you have to fill up a passenger locator form that you will be getting in the UK government website. So this is for everyone who comes from a country that needs to quarantine or self-isolate themselves for 14 days once they have reached the UK. So I am quarantining right now. If you want me to show you around my quarantine room, or things that I'm, you know, maybe what I eat in a day while quarantining here video, please do let me know. So yes, that is a bummer. You have to self-isolate for 14 days, which means you cannot go out for anything at all if you are self-isolating. So make sure that you choose a place where you're staying at, that you are going to get adequate food delivered to you, and you know, that you have enough supplies of things that you need to sanitize yourself. And what is most important is that you need to fill up that form where you need to give details of where you will be staying at for these 14 days, so that if something happens to you, you can be located, which is why it is called the passenger locator form. So yes, that is there. Now, after you have boarded the flight wearing the shield and the face mask, it's really bad, because you know, the mask gets very foggy very quickly, and it is of course uncomfortable, but it is important that you do keep on wearing mask, and you just wear your shield while you're flying, for your own safety and for the safety of those around you. It's absolutely so in the flight, there are a few things that you should keep in mind. I was told by the air hostess in my flight that they're not allowed to come in the cabin when they're not doing any service, which essentially means when they're not giving you any food. So you know what happened was, in the cabin luggage, where you put in the cabin luggage, it was open. So I had gone to ask for help, but I was told that I'm not allowed to come in the cabin. So I had to manage. I'm quite short, so it was difficult. But then again, I feel that if it is a rule enforced because of the COVID, then it is important that we abide by it. So that is the air hosts and the air hostesses. They were very, very, they were all wearing PPE kit. The plane was quite empty, so you're sitting, nobody sits in the seat beside you, and a person sits on the seat after that, so if there is a three-seat row. However, there were many seats where there was only one person sitting, so that was great. Coming to food, that was a bummer, because of COVID, food got, I'm going to show you the food that was served to us. So because it was a morning to afternoon flight, you know, late afternoon, so we were first given breakfast. In breakfast, we were all given packaged food, and there was no non-veg option, and there were no non-veg options, there was only veg. So the packaged food that was given to us is here in the picture. So there was, you know, it wasn't special, but it wasn't inedible either. There was this really bad veg puff sort of a thing, that was terrible. It had apart from that, the packaged cookie, the cake was really nice. There was fruity, it almost felt like, you know, when you were a kid and you, the day, say during your sports day or annual function day, you were given fancy packaged food from school, how they looked. So it looked like that. And I think Air India has some fascination with these salted peanuts, because it was also served to us during lunch. However, we were given the option of veg or non-veg. And with that, we were all asked to whether we wanted soft drink or beer. So you could choose either or. Lunch combination was weird, so we were but it was lovely. I loved it. So it was like, give me biryani in any form, I will love it anyway. So we were given bread, butter, peanuts, we were given a stuffed paratha, curd and chicken biryani and a curry. So it was really lovely. I loved it. And yeah, that was all the food that was served to us. So yeah, the flight reached before time, as I said previously. Of course, the passenger look at your form was asked for in the immigration. So everything that you should do, I think there are more precautions that you need to take before traveling. Of course, I was tensed for traveling, you know, during this time when the chances of catching the disease is very high. But I would say that the airport staff and the, you know, airline staff are doing fabulous job. They have been wonderful. You know, it must be so uncomfortable working in the PPE kits. But anyone and everyone who is doing their job with all the safety measures, following them perfectly, kudos to them. Really, we are very thankful to you for making things so safe for us, and ensuring that we are giving the best service among this very difficult times in our world. Yeah, that was how it went. It wasn't as crazy as I thought it was going to be. So here's hoping that things improve soon, and if you are going to travel, or if someone you love is going to travel soon, I hope that, you know, this video is helpful, that it did put your anxieties to some rest if you're worried, which definitely you should be. And I really hope that you enjoyed this video. If you wanted to know how the Kolkata to London direct flight was, so basically what I want to say is that if you enjoyed this video, please switch on the bell icon after you hit the subscribe button, give this video a big thumbs up, leave your comments down below. I would love to answer your questions, as it is I'm quarantining for 14 days, so I would love to answer your questions. If you have any questions regarding travel from India to the UK and what all you need to do, everything, just feel free to ask me in the comment section down below. I would love to hear from you, and I'm also going to see you very, very soon. Until then, please stay safe, take care, and I hope that everyone that you love remain well as well. I'll see you soon. Bye.